fear? Is there envy and strife amongst us? No, we don't have that. Through the grace of the Heavenly Father, we don't have that, man. Is there envy and strife amongst the great Millstone crew? Brother said, yeah. I'm kind of skeptical. I don't know. They're wild and they're crazy. But they kind of like got the respects of dogs. The most vicious dog, he's the leader. Go ahead and lead that track, man. Whoever come up most vicious, everybody step back and let them talk. Envy and strife amongst the Israelite churches, I'm sure they got it. I'm sure they got it with the marksman and the
KOC,
the great, all these guys envy and strife. It's confusion and an evil word. Right, Sean, what you got to finish that? Come on. James 3:17, right? But the wisdom that is from above is first pure, right? And peaceable, gentle, and easy to be entreated, right? The wisdom from on high is first pure, peaceable, gentle, easy to be entreated. The wisdom from the Lord is easy to step to that. Listen. Excuse me. It's a little chilly out. I got some ginger in my mouth. It's not gum. Understand this here, right? Wisdom from on high is gentle, peace, easy to be entreated. You got brothers in the street hollering that they hate the so-called white man. They hate America. None of the Gentiles can get saved. And everybody, they're all going to die. And we're the only ones to get salvation. I don't think that's easily entreated. I don't think nobody's really ready to accept that. Too tough. You understand? How does that sound, brother? If we stand and say that the white man, the Chinese man, the Japanese, the African, none of them gonna be saved. None of them. They can't get saved. Only me and you. Does that sound right?
Yeah, it sounds right.
But everybody got their opinion though. My Bible said God created all men.
Right? All right. Take care, boss.
God created all men, you know.
He created all men.
Right.
So all men got a shot to get salvation.
Yeah, that's true too. I think what you did.
Praise the Lord, but I was telling you, these other congregations, they believe only the Negroes, the Puerto Ricans can get salvation. They say no one else can get salvation. White men can't get saved. China men can't forget about it. That don't match up with the Bible. That's not good in the Bible. It doesn't match up with the Bible. Right? Finish this up. James 3:17, but the wisdom that is from above is first pure, then peaceable,
right?
Easy to be entreated. Easy to be entreated, full of mercy and good fruit,
right?
Without partiality, it's full of mercy and good fruit. The Lord is merciful. Now who is it to say he's not going to have mercy on Esau? Or Ammon, or Moab, or Amalek? Who is it to say the Lord's not going to have mercy on these tribes, man? Or these nations, we know that.
Without partiality and without hypocrisy. And the fruits of righteousness is sown in peace of them that make peace.
And the fruits of righteousness is sown in peace of them that make peace. Give me Psalm the 79th chapter. Read, pick up where you left off. Come on. Right.
Galatians 3:7. Know ye therefore that they which are of faith, the same are the children of Abraham.
The same are the children of Abraham. They which are of faith, the same are the children of Abraham. Abraham believed that it was counted to him for righteousness, man. Walk on through it, sorry. The same. Those that are of faith are the same. They're the same as the children of Abraham. Show them what you got out.
In the scripture, foreseeing that the Most High would justify the heathen through faith.
The Most High would justify the heathen through faith. So anybody can get it. The Lord said he's going to justify the heathen through faith. Read it again.
Galatians 3:8. In the scripture, foreseeing that the Most High would justify the heathen through faith,
right,
preach before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, in thee shall all nations be blessed.
Right, that's how this thing go, man. So when the Lord tell Abraham that, pull it out, Genesis 12.
why they can't just pay attention.
The fact of the matter is, the Lord said he told Abraham, long time, everybody is going to get blessed if they act like you act, because you're a righteous brother. You believe me when I told you to take your son and sacrifice him, man. And you went to go do it. For that, you're my man. For that, you're the child of faith, the father of faith. Father of faith for Abraham. Believe. Believe what the Lord say. That's what we're reading. Right out of the Bible. Check this out.
Genesis 18:18. 18 to 17. And the Lord said, 18 to 18. Seeing that Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation.
Right.
And all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him.
All the nations of the earth shall be blessed in Abraham. The Lord said this long time before these jokers popped up in New York City. We know that.
For I know him that he will command his children and his household after him.
I know him. The Lord said, I know Abraham. He gonna teach his wife. He gonna teach his son, his daughter. He gonna create, guide them all in right works. He not gonna come up on the worldwide platform and tell everybody, you don't need to teach your woman, skip her. She can go off her own way. She's wicked, she can't learn. Brother say, I mean, forget the children, man. He said, come in, get your woman, lie to the woman. Don't even tell her that you got good knowledge. Like the brother said, lie. He said, don't even tell the woman, you take off your garment, take off your priest garment. Guess what the brother said? The brother said what we should do. After today, say after sundown we finish. We should take off our garments. Put it in a bag and hide it. Then he goes step to the little girl you're checking out, who you was rapping to, right? And go in, you know, visit her, have a night, lay down with her, better now. And don't never tell her nothing right. Don't never tell her nothing about the Bible. And don't tell her that you preach the Bible. Don't tell her nothing. You just need to lay down and get some warmth from her that night. You think that's right, huh?
Nope. I don't think it's right.
No, that's outrageous, brother.
Outrageous?
Yeah, that's some hypocritical stuff if you ever want to know it, man.
Well, Tahar taught him that, brother. Tahar taught him
that. Yeah, that thing got his brother Tahar.
I would say, dude, you should be holy, brother, like you said.
In the Lord.
No, you should be holy, brother. You got to be pure, man. You can't come up with, are you going to abuse your own sister? It's your woman, and now you're going to go lie to her and don't tell her about Christ, and you know about Christ? What kind of brother is that? Must be out of your mind. Must be crazy, man. Show them what you got out. Huh?